Hello, sir, all of them. Today, I am going to talk about right now the present scientific world, the most addressed issue is climate change and climate vulnerability. Assessment framework for sustainable river systems. As we know that our civilization grow near to the rivers, across the rivers, from Gangetic to any in the cross of a world like Mississippi or any other river basins. So, why it's important to discuss about the basic concepts, what we have to do, what implications on the environment we have to address when we are going for quantitative analysis or modeling sector of climate change. So my outlines for this presentation is what is a climate vulnerability, livelihood effect indexes, livelihood vulnerability index, and the framework conceptual view. What we are going to propose is DSCER framework. So this is actually a picture. It's from last year, the tsunami came in Uttarakhand, the heavy flood. The Uttarakhand was witnessed about the some kind of climate change as well as the pressure from the human kinds. So it is not directly related to the climate change, but it is the most induced by the human man. So in the recent past, the world witnessed many natural calamities from and socio-political conflicts like Narmada and the Roorkee dams and Odisha's floods. So how we are going to assess that? First, two parts are there in when we are going to climate studies. One part is modeling and another part is the economic aspect of and social aspect of the climate, which is going to affect the society. In the normal sense, the climate is a narrow vision with average weather and some mean and variant of climatic data, rainfall, temperature variations into the area. But IPCC is coming with the definition of climate change as any change in the climate over a time period, whether due to natural variability or as a result of human activities or induced by the man-made. At the same time, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change try to address the climate change is a change of climate which is attributed directly or indirectly to the human activities that alters the composition of global atmosphere and which is in addition to the natural climate variability observed over the compared time of periods. So the change is not sudden, it from the of the long period, over the long period, it has to be expressed or it has to be observed. And what are the impacts is going to be on the society that will address all climate vulnerability. Like we are exposed towards the climate and how we are going to adapt. Then we can address the adaptation policies into that. So to address those vulnerability, what is it going to impact on the environment or society, we have to address those in indexes. Like first, which is the most important, is livelihood vulnerability index. Because when climate is going to impact on the society, it is going to affect the livelihood, the person, the least person or the poor or to the poorest. So objective of the poverty index is to understand and estimate a relative measure and special pattern of poverty in the dependent community in the region. Like in Odisha, this is the figure of Odisha last year. So after that, they are still struggling for their livelihood. So how we are going to assess that? We are going to address with the livelihood vulnerability index. Livelihood vulnerability index reflects three indicators: adaptive capacity, sensitivity, and exposure. And having seven dimensions: socio-demographic profile, like how the society is especially contributing in the region; livelihood strategies, what are the livelihood aspects of the society into the region; social networks, health, food, water, and natural disasters or natural calamities. To calculate the livelihood vulnerability index, we have to go through this. And here LVI is vulnerability index, which is going to be measured as summation I equal to 1 to 7, that is the dimensions of indexes, indicators, WM of and into MVI, which is a highest dimension values of that particular dimension, if we are talking about food, water, whatever. And WMI is the weight measured of that particular dimension into the space. So these are indicators what we got, like we listed. For adaptive capacity, there is a three: socio-demographic profile, livelihood strategies, social networks. In socio-demographic, so community dependency ratio of the particular community into the region, or percentage of family-headed households. We can check that if they are in a particular family, this family is not there, so who is going to head that family? And that is going to affect the livelihood of the particular family. Then livelihood strategies through percentage of household with the orphans, percentage of household of the dependent shows. Sensitivity through health, food, and water. Then next is exposure. Exposure towards the natural disaster or vulnerability. That can be measured as percentage of household reporting injuries or deaths, or percentage of households reported in the literature, that can be reduced. Number two is livelihood effect indexes. I deal with natural, human, financial, and physical capital of the particular region. This also provide the household based composite index. Like a particular house is depend on the human number of family members, then how they are financially dependent on each other, and then how the families and the region is dependent on the full family as a physical capital. For that, the vulnerability indicators based on spatial and non-spatial both elements, because the community is for the village and village is for the community concept. That can also be quantified using the same formula. These are the indicators what we went through various reports. One of the paper I quoted here, that N.S. Rabindranath and Khajuria's 2012 papers, and that IPCC reports on vulnerability, which is headed by the ISC team. I was also part of that. This indicators, when we finalize these indicators, the human capital, which contains health, food, knowledge, and skills; natural capitals, land, forest, water, and other natural resources, which are vulnerable to the climate, social capital, demography, network and relationship, financial capital, the finance, which are dependent, the families, how it is dependable on that. Fiscal capital is communication, daily needs. So we came, these are the indicators which is exposed towards the climate change. So some questions came into mind, like what is happening on the environment and why, like how the environment is exposed towards the vulnerability, and how the human beings going to suffer with them, how we are going to quantify those. To address that, before the modeling sector, we move towards modeling and we project for 2020s or 2050s, or long term goals or short term goals. So we have come with a one framework. This is DSCER, that driver, cause, state, effects and response. So DSCER framework first came in 2002 in European industry, European countries, and they came with like what are the state, what are the forces which are driving to the this impacts, and then pressure, those factor drivers are putting pressure on the state to become vulnerable, and what are the impacts and what is the response for the adaptation against those climate vulnerability. Sometimes this referred as indirectly or underlying drivers as a force, and referred to the fundamental process in the society which drive the having impacts on the environment. So like industrialization or mining, we have to move our economy for meet to the population growth. So these are the drivers, this will work as a drivers. Then we have to state what are the pressures. So pressures will be like degradation of environment, depletion of water tables. These can be the pressure, and states can be the society, the particular community that which is dependent on the pressure or the natural resources directly or indirectly. Like one example, in deforestation, the state of the state is the forest, and the pressure is and or impact is the community who are going to depend on that, the livelihood going to be affected by the state or the pressure induced by the economic growth. So we came with the one framework which is like driving force. We composed all this the framework, and we came with driving force, adaptation, response, impacts, and these the driving force or pressures, they are going to affect on the state, and which is going to affect socio-economic conditions of the community, and those communities are vulnerable towards the climate. Then water vulnerability, because the most of the communities who are near to the they have to be depends on the forest or natural resources or the river for their livelihood. So those the water or river basin is going to be vulnerable because exploitation of the resources from there. So this has to be addressed, and whatever the measures we are going to take from this, its adaptation to mitigate those impacts. This is the functionality, how it works. Like driver, pressure and state is interlinked to each other. These are the cause. And then what are the response, or what is the impact, and then our response towards the solution. It came under the consequences and solution, which is the in terms of science is adaptation and mitigation of climate change impacts. We propose this the driver, state, cause, effect, the, with the functionality driver, state, cause, effect and response. We came with some indicators and some measures we have to take in recording with the parameters we set, like water quality, groundwater, ecology, chemical and physical and biological composition when we are going to treat as the agriculture, and how we are going to like impacts going to be measured through loss of habitats, eco health, crop productivity, water crisis, irrigation. So if we have to address the challenges of climate change, and we are moving towards the modeling for projecting for new future or short term or long term goals, we have to be come with some indicators, and we have to check the frames that responses and drivers. We have to be first take care of them, and then we have to move for planning. Thank you.
Next water sets, natural resource for our livelihoods.